No, okay. Okay, let's review what we learned from last week a little bit. Okay. Last week is LCA. Okay. So you know that is the part of ISO. Okay. 14,040. Okay. And you know it declare, you know, the content in this series that, you know, like for LCA, you have to have goal and score. LCI phase, LICA, this is like a life cycle impact assessment. This one is like a life cycle inventory and interpretation. Okay. This one is like a very important component. Okay, goal, life cycle inventory, life cycle impact assessment, even though they have same eye. But first eye is inventory, the second eye is impact. And the fourth one, interpretation. Okay. So last week you see the difference between goal and score. Goal means statement, okay, that you declare about the objective. But you know, score, it tells you about to say that boundary, okay, when we are wrong, something like that, okay. Product system, functional unit, system boundary, okay. So another thing that also important, you know, from last week, this one tell you about, you know, like the series of ISO that regarding to LCA, the history, okay. And last week you learn about goal. Goal, it said must be said intent of use, reason for starting audience. Okay, and say that whether it for comparative and disclose to public or not. Okay. And you know, like scope tell you about function and functional unit, system boundary, what is like life cycle assessment, impact assessment methodology, and data. And also data collection. Okay. So this one will tell you about the next step and how you collect data. And also, you know, like if you would like to do impact assessment, you know, you would like to understand about, you know, impact. So we can separate impact into several classification and also several indication, you know, from last time. So, and also characterization model, you know, from last time. And you learn about goal, functional, and functional unit. I think last time we already learned about this thing, right? That, you know, like LCA is not the same as other environmental impact, because they declare as functional unit. So we not do LCA for light bulb, for one bulb, because they have no meaning. So they mentioned about lumen. If they would like to do LCA for the car, they said, you know, like how, you know, the kilometer passenger required to for that bus, and also housing. I think you learned about this one in last week class about a lamp, so we can do a comparison between regular lamp, compact fluorescent, and LED bifunctional. That, you know, you have to able to compare the different if you can use for million lumen hour of light. Okay, so the important things for functional unit, you have specified quantity, quality, duration to provide, you know, like the exact meaning for functional unit. Okay, remember last week, you know, if you would like to compare these two, You need to compare that you have, yeah, you would like compare three bags that have a function to carry somewhere. Okay, for example, 5 kilo of grocery on 10 trip. Okay, and you see this one also for a car. And you know, like you can, I think this one you already see some example that, you know, be divided by kilometer travel per passenger. If in an average car, you carry 1.5, you need to divide it to get, you know, like one passenger, okay? And last week, we also learned about, you know, like when you declare, you know, like for, you know, like score, you need to declare system boundary, okay? This one also important for you. And you know, like typically, you know, you learn about process for diagram. I think this one is not so difficult for you, okay, to break down. But the system, you know, like might be, you know, for example, something that you have called product. You might thinking whether you include or exclude, you know, how could you compare two kind of system, okay? Last week we learned about, you know, like a called ethanol. At the beginning for this one, you know, they including, you know, since, you know, like a farm infrastructure, manufacturing, ethanol product, equipment. So we study from, you know, like machine and production and farming. Okay, but we include the grain processing over here. Okay, and this one they mentioned about cut-off criteria. And if you have a problem with co-product, that's what you do from last week example. And as really mentioned that this week, you know, we're gonna continue on life cycle state and so on. As you know, you learned from last week that, you know, this one the definition from, you know, the ISO, okay, phase over here. It means, you know, how we work, okay, goal, inventory analysis, impact assessment, interpretation, but stage. It means, you know, how could you break down this one into small steps, you know, from cradle to grave, okay? So this one is start from extraction, manufacturing, use, and dispose. So we can divide it. If you will see from this diagram into A1 extraction or upstream production. And actually, you know, like once you got this product, you need to transport this one to manufacturing. You have A2 transport to factory. Okay. And after that, you know, from manufacturing, for example, if you would like to do some kind of building, okay. You need to transport this one to construction site. But you need another transport. So you have A4, A5, and after that they use the product. Okay, this one gonna be the call B1 to 7, and after that, you know, this one is out of use. Then you do demolition and disposal. Okay. So if you see from this diagram. Start from A1, A2, A3, they call this one cradle to gate. Okay, to prep, it means until die, right? This one is, you can see that before you go to construction site, so they call this one cradle to gate. And if you include A4, it's called cradle to site, okay? And, you know, during construction, you go to A5, cradle to construction. If until, you know, the end of life, your demolition of the building is cradle to grave. Sometimes you might see the word, you know, instead of cradle to grave, they might use the word cradle to gate. Okay, so you will see that it depends on different stage. Okay. So let's see, this one is life cycle of transportation flow. It starts by, for example, this one at oil well. They have four action. You send it to refinery plant. Okay, you have processing. And this one with product storage. You might travel, okay, through a ship. Okay, so this one is, you will see, you know, and the way. And after that, this ship is sent it to a large storage, a bulk storage. And transport to, you know, like a distribution and go to vehicle. So they use, for example, for this one, in this green barrel from wheel to pump. And this one from pump to wheel, okay? Pump, it means gas station, okay? But for the whole thing, they call from wheel to wheel, okay? And this one is show you, you know, like a diagram, you know, that if you would like to define system boundary, mainly be divided to raw material extrusion, manufacturing, use or reuse, and maintenance, recycle or waste. So this one from top to the bottom. On the left hand side is input, on the right hand side is waste. That release from each state. Okay. Typically, you know, like right now, you know, I have another slide show you that right now they have a software, free software available and also paid software. But I not recommend the paid software because it's so expensive. Ajahn Nattaporn bought one license for 1 year, I think cost it almost 200,000 baht. I think it's too much to pay. Right, because I think it's not that difficult. One thing that I think it's difficult to do is to get the data. It's one of the things that most expensive or most time consuming to do. Okay, if you see here, typically, we divided it to four main stages. Raw material, processing, manufacturing, use, dispose. And you have something in between, transportation, right, in between. I remember that, you know, the project of one student under Ajahn Nattaporn, you know, like he did a life cycle of shampoo. So he do, you know, the process, you know, like the manufacturing using Unilever, okay, to be manufacturing. So for raw material upstream processing, you need to check, you know, like the chemical that made that shampoo where it came from. Okay. And after that, he used Google Map, okay, to count the location from the company to Unilever company to get information, you know, from, you know, to bring raw material to the plant. And also just meaning about it, after Unilever produce the shampoo, okay, it need to send transport to customer, okay, he also tell, you know, to the distance from Unilever to main distributor, okay. And after that, you know, during usage and reuse, he also how, you know, how many shampoo per, you know, if people clean their hair or how much water they need. So he calculate amount of wastewater that also produce, okay, during usage of, you know, shampoo and people clean. And after that, you know, like you have, for example, packaging, right? And you need to throw it away. So this one is a step for this post, you know, the packaging, okay? So, you know, it depends on, you know, how far you would like to go. At that, the project of student that done, he just stopped at, you know, like the company that produced the chemical. But if you like to track further, you can deep down, maybe the end point might be to do mining, to be like, for example, fuel or material, okay? Exploration or other things. So depend on whether, so this one is, tell you about scope that, you know, if you would like to handle material extraction or upstream processing, it might involve, for example, material extraction, mining or exploration. And also, oh, sorry. Do another thing that also important, upstream processing. For example, if you would like to do life cycle for a car, the main processing for a car is manufacturing type, assembly, but you need to get information, for example, for the company that made a pipe, a company that made, for example, tire, wire. So this is included in, you know, like material extraction upstream processing. This about transformation of raw material into form of, you know, useful for manufacturing. Okay. So, you know, you might study about equipment, fuel use, land use, water use, and waste that came out. And manufacturing is the main, okay, just a main process that involve to producing our product. So it depends whether, you know, what is your product. I do show the example that I searched from the internet about to producing polyethylene. So your product for producing polyethylene, you know, manufacturing that produce polyethylene. Your product is, you know, it PE in pellet form, okay? So this one is transforming energy raw material into product and packing them for distribution, okay? So you need to consider energy use, raw material use, chemical and waste, equipment and co-product. Okay. After, you know, you produce, you send it to the user, okay? So you need to thinking about whether the use of this one, you need to reuse, you need to maintenance, you need to account for everything. For example, for a car, you might to change a lube oil, change the brake oil, so you need to count everything. Okay, for example, they mentioned this one, if you have the lawn mower, okay, you need to thinking how often do you use side of lawn, lifetime and quality for lubricant and other parts. So we add all things. So let's see if you see here, okay, example product with varying in level of use impact. Okay, for example, if you use ruler, nothing involved, right? But if, for example, if you use skidder, you need to specify how frequent that you use. Okay, did you need to replace a new thing, dump the old thing? You have television, you also need to count electricity. If, for example, life cycle for TV, for using for, let's say that 1,000 hours, okay, you need to also add, you know, like waste that generate from electricity, right? You previously, you have to count this one. And for this washer, you need electricity, you need soap, you need water, and you provide waste water. As I already mentioned for shampoo, right? You also need to add water, right, to clean. You got wastewater. So this is a scope that you need to do. This will provide you information if you do for a car. You know, like you need to provide input gasoline, oil, coolant, brake, you know, washer fluid, seal replacement part, blade pad, tire. And this one is waste, okay? You know, tire and brake wear, used tire. Okay, oil coolant leak and other things. Okay, And after your end of life, okay, no longer uses, you have to thinking about, you know, what you're gonna do. For example, if you're not, you know, you also, if you recycle, you can bring that one back. If you remember the example that I showed you before about lube oil, that, you know, if you use, you know, the same process, or you use, you know, the recycle for another process, and then you can subtract, okay, the data, because you can recycle your product. But if, for example, you know, like the end of use, you know, you can, for example, dumping, okay, incineration, and if you would like to reuse, you might bring something for distillation. So this one, you know, you need to consider all other things. As I mentioned to you that, you know, like Thailand greenhouse gas organization, you know, they provide you some Excel file for you to calculate how clean. But that one is just proposed, actually carbon dioxide. But the one that most useful is LCA. So you see, you know, like the whole process that, you know, like waste and energy that use. Okay. So let's see. This one is brown. Okay, for plastic water bottle. Okay. You know, like you have, for example, you know, the example that what you do. Okay. So if you see here, plastic water bottle production from raw material, you do label, packaging, distribution, you use. So you have three options. Refill, okay, and reuse. Okay. You might throw in trash. Okay, and you might throw in a recycle bin, and this one can recycle back, okay, to use it. So this one is example of, you know, like when we study about life cycle. And also, you know, like for transportation, I already mentioned to you that if you would like to do, you have to know exact, you calculate how long, okay, how many kilo, what type of the car that they use to travel. And for example, in one truck, if they carry how many kilo, so after that, you know, you define functional unit, and you can calculate in a per trip how many gasoline that use per trip. Okay, so for transportation, I have to say that it's not that difficult, because they have a lot of database, okay, that provide you, okay, for example, energy consumption, okay, per fuel type, per type of car, and other things. Okay, so this one is for transport. So, you know, you need to thinking whether they use railway, ship, use pipeline, use aircraft, use a truck, or use, you know, a multi mode of the car. Okay, this one is like tell you about score and goal. So let I move on to show you part two. I think I need to turn off this one. Actually, you know, like if you are interested, you know, in this software, you know, not a software they have, you know, like they provide, okay, you the PowerPoint with style. But for me, I cut justly some part. I don't know how could I get rid of this one. I need to go to animation, right? How to turn off. I forgot. Transition. Oh, go to record.
No.
So I just bring only a few pieces of, you know, this part to show you, but you know, for the whole document they have, let's say that, you know, 30 of them, you know, but I just like bring one that, you know, like most important to talk with you, because you know, the rest of that document, you know, if you don't have time, you know, like, you can follow me, but if you would like to study in more detail, you can follow them. Okay. Do you know how to get rid of the sound here? I forgot it. If you see the PowerPoint and have a sound, I forgot to stop. Because I have a sound in every page. Maybe I open PDF file, right, to be easier, right? Oh, this is easy, right? Right, have to close, right? Oh, okay. It should be easier, right? Okay, using only myself. So this one, the easiest one, right? Okay. Can you show that, you know, I keep just only some part that important, okay? After you define goal and score, right, already, after that, as already mentioned, you know, you start to do some kind of calculation. But before you do calculation, let me explain about the way that, you know, in part of interpretation, okay? So let's see that, you know, like, once you write, you calculate. Okay, so if you remember, we break down our step. We know raw material that we put. We know waste that we came out, okay? Before, you know, like we do, we show you the calculation, let I show you that, you know, like, the way that they interpret, okay, the effect, you know, this one is just only the common type of impact, okay? Typically, you know, like, the common type of impact, they divide it to expectation, potential, or AP. Global warming of climate change potential, GWP, smog, ozone, or photochemical oxidant, they call SCP, stratospheric ozone depletion, they call ODP. This one, I'm sorry. This four, you know, this one and also number five, this one is for criteria air potential, they call HHAP air pollutant. And the rest, you know, is about something to water. This one is eutrophication for water, and this one for toxic. Okay. Mostly you can see that they interplay into air pollution related. Okay. There might be wider impact into this category as well, but not so often. So let's see, you know, for individual one, this one is acidification. You know why when they burn oil, okay, something that might be released, you know, from, you know, like the burning of the fuel, for example, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, NOx. This chemical, you know, like once it released to atmosphere, it convert to the chemical, for example, carbon dioxide, it can convert to carbonic acid. Okay, nitrogen dioxide can convert to nitric acid. Sulfur dioxide can convert to sulfuric acid and can change form. Okay, that kind of chemical, you know, can, you know, dissolve into cloud droplet. Okay, So it changes, you know, from gas to liquid. And after that, you know, it can deposition, you know, into ground. You know, you can see this one show you the cycle. When you're burning things, is convert. And after that, you know, like dissolve to the cloud. And everything after that is falling down. So this one we call wet deposition. Okay. It came down as so they call wet, W-E-T. Okay, and another mechanism for it coming down, we call dry deposition. Okay. You know, like once, you know, like in the atmosphere, they have some kind of humidity. You know, like the gas phase can be so. And get rid of the atmosphere by wet deposition. But if there are no rain, okay, they are also able to come down by what we call dry deposition from the principle that we learn in fluid mechanics, Stokes law, right? So you learn about particle mechanics. So it's able to go down. So you will see that, you know, like this one is released to atmosphere, it also able to going down. But the area that is going down might be a bit far away from the source. Depend on, you know, how long the pollutant can be traveled. Okay, also depend on the meteorological condition, for example, wind speed, wind direction, okay? So, you know, like the effect in this one, because, you know, like once it dissolved to this one, it made, you know, like the pH of water to be lower. Okay. Actually, you know, like I also work with Taiwanese scientists. Taiwanese, you know, like Taiwan is an island on the left hand side of China and also Southeast Asia. Actually, they're measuring the pH of rainwater in the mountain area during, you know, like burning season in Southeast Asia, in Myanmar, north of Thailand, and also Vietnam. You know, air pollutant can travel far away to Taiwan, and they found out that the pH of rainwater in the mountain area, it lower to 5, pH go down to 5. So, you know, so that's why, you know, they came to Thailand and also Vietnam to study. So what going on, you know, how pollutant travel. So this one, you know, it made, you know, the rainwater over there to be what we call acid rain. And also, you know, like Japan is a country that on the left hand side of China and other countries as well. Also Japan, they experience acid rain as well. So they need to do a program to help the country on the right side to get rid of the coal and other things, you know, otherwise, you know, they cannot solve the problem in that country because air pollutant can travel to other region. So typically, you know, like they're gonna report, if you see here, in terms of kilogram of sulfur equivalent. LCA, you know, like one thing that I saw that they try to standardize and grouping impact. Because pollutant, you know, they are variety. There are many pollutants, so they're grouping pollutants that can affect, you know, acid rain and convert amount of pollutant to be sulfur dioxide equivalent, okay, to be represent, okay, something related to acidification potential. They might put into equivalent of hydronium ion, Okay. So this one is, you know, and if you see here, they also mentioned that, you know, you see this impact. It also affects local and regional, so everybody can travel far away. So let's see that, you know, like if, for example, if you consider, you know, like acid education potential, what type of activity that might involve, okay, they said the major activity is fuel combustion, okay? And because this one you use for producing electricity, you also use for doing agricultural and also use for transportation, okay? So that's why European Union, they made a standard for the fuel for use for engine in Euro. From the advertisement, they said, you know, the fuel is Euro 5, or I think it's spec for the fuel. And what is substance? Nitrogen oxide, NOx is nitrogen oxide. So they call SOX, sulfur oxide, and ammonia. So I think the chair of this one is almost equal. And what the effect? Okay, they increasing soil and water acidity. And what the effect? You know, effect in the line of plant. You see the picture over there? Because the acid rain look like, you know, this one is washing by, you know, the acid. Okay, the leaf change the color to be, you know, like a yellow or white, and the leaf is falling down. So you can see the effect. And also effect to organism and building. So the construction of building is going to be, you know, corrode from acidification. And how about global warming? Okay, if you see scale of impact, it's global, it's not local or, you know, like the regional. So you see that the effect of this one is different. Typically, you know, this one is the main, you know, like a substandard many countries, you know, like are focused on. Because, you know, increasing in like greenhouse gas is causing, you know, like the climate, okay, climate change. Right now, because, you know, I usually heard, you know, I listen to green web, you know, when I drive a car from my home to university, I heard the DJ use the word in Thai, log ruin, okay, in right word, right, for climate change, because they use word in Thailand because temperature can be extremely hot or extremely cold. In some area, you have a lot of bright rain. Some area you have a drought, so I think they use a rifle, you know, to represent kind of change. They use ruin in Thai, okay. So this one, you know, like also very important that we gonna add, you know, like into LCA. And one thing that, you know, like because, you know, CO2 is not easy to get rid of. So the lifetime of this one is very, very high, scale is maybe 100 years. Typically, they convert everything to kilo carbon dioxide equivalent, okay? Come on, okay? So let's see, what is the major source for global warming potential? Again, fuel combustion, similar to acid rain. Also, agricultural, already mentioned when I teaching you about air pollution, that when we go on our rice, we put a lot of fertilizer. We keep water to let the paddy to grow. So you create condition we call anaerobic. And condition for anaerobic, and it produce methane. So the growing rice field, you produce a lot of greenhouse gas. And also, you know, industrial process. What is chemical that release? Carbon dioxide, methane. So this 80%, 9%. And this one is If you see nitrate oxide, ozone, water, and also CFC and other about 11%. What is, you know, the midpoint increasing radiative forcing? I think this month, if you, during the morning when you wake up, you might feel that, you know, someday you feel a little bit, you know, like you see outside, it look like cloudy, and you feel a little bit that, you know, the temperature is, you know, not as warm as you expect. You know, this one is like they say that the midpoint effect, because, you know, like the particulate or CO2, that effect, you know, global warming also do something different, right? Now the particle that you see, you know, during this month, you know, in Bangkok in February, you know, like the particulate scattered, the scattering, you know, effect, you know, it cool down atmosphere. So, you know, PM, you know, can do both cool down and also, you know, some black carbon they absorb, right? It made some we feel, you know, like a warmer. But CO2, it global warming potential to be positive one to get, you know, like the atmosphere to be warm. You will see every morning, you know, when you look at your window, you know, you feel different way, you know, because, you know, the particle and also some gases in atmosphere. Okay, this one is move here. And this one is, you know, like increase in radiative forcing. So what the endpoint, sea level increase in severe weather frequency within the ocean current change, soil moisture loss, increase in heat related illness. So this one is something related to global warming potential. How about ozone? I already mentioned to you that ozone is, you know, happening because of photochemical reaction. You know, like where, you know, the activity of car or, you know, like in industry, they release nitrogen dioxide, they release white volatile compound. Once the sunlight came, okay, they call photochemical reaction. It's not typical reaction that we learn in chemical kinetics. In chemical kinetics is what I said that it's thermal. You use energy to increase activation energy, but photochemical reaction, sunlight. You know, like sunlight can be, you know, wave and photon. If you remember when you learn physics, photon from sunlight can activate, okay, energy and create chemical reaction, okay? It produces ozone. And as already mentioned to you, this one is, you know, also that produce, you know, like in stratosphere, this one in our Earth, this one troposphere, this one stratosphere, also in troposphere, able to filter some UV, but also on that produce because of, you know, car equity and manufacturing carbon is a bad ozone, okay? And how about ozone? You know, ozone in stratosphere, okay? When it depleting, okay, it's global effect, okay? Why? Because you lack of good ozone to filter UVB, okay? So this one harmful for the people who live nearby, you know, like in the pool, for example, country in, for example, Australia, New Zealand, okay, they got affected, you know, because of ozone hole, okay. So that we have, you know, Montreal Protocol to get rid of some CFC since 1981. And we're going to calculate the, you know, amount of this one in terms of CFC 11 equivalent, okay, for this one. So let's see where it came from. Manufacturing of polymer and aerosol. the chemical that causing ozone, for example, nitrate oxide. The company that I was already mentioned, that Ube chemical that produce, you know, raw material for polyester, also, you know, like produce nitrate oxide as well. But Ube Thailand, they do modification of their process to get rid of, okay, nitrate oxide. And they can claim, you know, like the carbon credit. Okay, that, you know, like they make modification of their plants. But then the other side, global warming potential is quite high. I forgot, it might 100 or 1,000 tons of CO2. So, you know, if the company, they know and they do modification, they can get rid of, you know, like ozone depletion potential. And also fire extinction refrigerants. So what kind of chemical? How long? These are the chemical for, you know, like used for fire extinction. CFC, okay, and HFC used for refrigerant. Midpoint, decreasing saturated ozone. What the endpoint? Skin cancer, club damage, material damage, only life. Yeah, I think there, in this slide, they made summarize in impact quite well. What next? Smog creation potential. Actually, this one is also related to ozone, but this one is effect. You know, the effect is local. You see this car, and there in the city that you cannot see. You know, the object in front of you quite well because visibility is so low. Okay, why this situation we call smog? Smog plus fog is smog. Okay, what chemical that create these things? Photochemical oxidant. Okay, it formed from reaction of nitric oxide, VOC, and other pollutants. Okay, so we can calculate this one into kilo of ozone equivalent, kilogram of, this one is ethylene, kilogram of NOx equivalent. So where smog came from? Car, industry, energy production. So we, what it means, substance, NOx and VOC. And this one is increasing in ground level ozone. Ozone depletion, we focus on stratospheric ozone, but this one is tropospheric ozone. So they are different. The one, that one is different, you know, something regarding to cancer, okay? Right, then, not able to screen UV for us, but this one we live with ozone. So the causing, reducing in lung and lung function, you know, it trigger asthma, it clot damage, and also affect eye irritation. So ozone in troposphere, you know, like you have to be careful. You know, right now I know that, 3 years ago, there are some kind of technology that they also use for household. Actually, for me, I have a cat, not a cat, I have 4 cats with me. You know, I'm thinking about, you know, in my room, I already have, you know, some kind of filter, okay? But I think, you know, I still, you know, thinking about a wearable technology to get rid of some bad smell. So you can see that right now they have a wearable technology for some ionization, plasma technology, and other things. But if you read deep into inside of that one, then what you use plasma, you can produce also. You know, like they use technology also to kill some kind of, you know, like a gel, right? For me, I'm thinking whether is it appropriate for use in a bedroom or not. I'm not quite sure, but for me, I'm scared. because I know about Mosulim. But you know, right now I know that these typically they use in hospital. Okay, because you know they can get rid of some germ and other thing. But if you are in a closed room, it's kind of dangerous, right? You know, if amount of ozone that produced, if it, you know, they cannot control in amount that, you know, lower in very small concentration, we not quite sure because the technology is still not cool whether it appropriate for use in closed room or not. So for me, I'm not buying any, you know, like air cleaner system that have that kind of technology first, right? Because you have the thinking, because also in, even though it goes for killing germ, but also able to, oh, this one go by itself. Okay, it also able to, you know, like aggregate asthma, also eye irritation, also make your lung function to be bad. Okay, so you can see this is a common thing that highlight in bold. Okay. For the rest, you know, like it might not consider quite often as, you know, like a smoke, okay, also nutrition, global warming and acidification, okay. So this one it tell you. And the rest of this one is, I think one of the key issue that they might use for wastewater is the last one, eutrophication, okay? As already we mentioned here, eutrophication, they said, is local impact, okay? You see this kind of photo, eutrophication. If in water reservoir, okay, they have a lot of nitrogen, they have a lot of phosphorus, okay, that might come from, for example, fertilizer. Okay, you have, for example, cutting field nearby, and you know the overflow water came to that area. Nitrogen, phosphorus. If you remember, you when you are young, you learn NPK. It's good for plant. Okay, to grow, right? So the plant, the aquatic plant can grow, you know, increasing. So the situation made a lot of plants, aquatic plant, a lot of aquatic plant, oxygen in water is limited. So this means, you know, like oxygen is depleted and made condition of water to be not enough for any animal to stay. So the water quality is going to be bad. You know, this one is leading to, you know, the problem. And you might also able to observe if, you know, example, you have a fish bowl. You keep feeding a fish a lot of food. It's more than your fish can take. And you grow some kind of, you know, like aquatic plant, you're gonna observe that aquatic plant is going so fast, right? Suddenly your water bowl, like your fish bowl, change the color from clear to clean. This one is, you know, easiest example to show. If you look around, you know, a water pond around us, if you see the color is changed to green, you see that this is the condition for eutrophication. So that means, you know, nitrogen or phosphorus is more than, you know, the plant or animal can take. Okay. So where is major source? Agricultural runoff, storm or wastewater, septic, seepage, process for air combustion. So you have major substance, nitrogen, phosphorus, NOx, and ammonia. And it causes excessive biological growth. and employed dead aquatic life, loss of biodiversity, and very bad order for wastewater, for water. What next? Human toxic potential. Okay. This one might be local, regional, or global impact. Okay. You know, if you use some kind of chemical, okay, we can divide that chemical to be carcinogenic and non-carcinogenic. So this one impact to human health. So technically, the major chemical that they use to represent benzene. Okay, in terms of, you know, benzene equivalent. So this one is, you know, like a carcinogenic or cancer. About choline for non-cancer. You can see that, right? Benzene, choline is common solvent that we use. So benzene is more toxic than choline. Okay, it's carcinogen. So where it came from? Okay, human toxicity, mining, agricultural, manufacturing, or energy production. What is main substance? Dioxin. Dioxin is, you know, the chemical that mine is from burning. Okay. One thing that, you know, if you're burning some material and also human core, if you not burn at the right temperature, you create, you know, a toxic chemical, okay? So in Thailand, Pollution Control Department, they have a campaign to replace, you know, like a normal, okay, funeral, okay, in the temple, you know, to be typical way they use only single, okay, and they change the unit to be need to make sure that they get rid of the carcinogen and dioxin, you know, from burning, not just only human core, also, for example, plastic waste and other things. So, you know, for me, you know, like, right now, I'm not sure whether you know or not, right now in Onnut, they have incineration plant. They just finished building maybe about 1 year. You know, right now, you know, one thing that for me, I not recommend to build the incineration of waste in the area if you not control it very well and did not have a best control technology. Because if you not control the burning very well, toxic chemical can be released. For me, I have a chance, you know, like I went to a meeting for environmental engineering in Busan, Korea. In Busan, they also have, you know, the plan for incineration of waste, but they pay a lot of money to control air pollution there. So my friend, he mentioned that, you know, the cost of control technology there is equally to a Lamborghini. He said it's so expensive. Because, you know, they would like to put in the city, you know, Busan of Korea in the city for, you know, for tourist attraction if they didn't control very well. For me, I'm not quite sure that in Onnut area, how much they pay, okay, to invest, you know, if they did not use the best technology, you know, the people who live nearby going to be suffering. And right now, I think that
people in that area, they made a complaint to the governor of Bangkok about the incineration of waste in Onnut.
Because the way that they handle the waste is not that good. Okay. And also this one, you know, like also toxic chemical, chromium, arsenic, zinc, benzopyrene and formaldehyde. This one come from, you know, the activity that use solvent. Okay, midpoint, you know, like the effect to human health, they can lead into asthma, cancer, heart disease, and low birth rate. Okay, Another thing that they also mentioned the effect, you know, for using chemical and activity in the LCA, they call ecotoxicity. Scale is local. If you release, you know, some kind of wastewater to water body, okay. You know, in water body, you have, you know, like small animal, right? Big animal, for example, small fish, big fish, and other things. You know, like the polar bear, you know, can go to the fish and other than human, right? Fishing and bring the fish to eat. So, you know, the cycle, you know, it, you know, they were in. So, you know, as I think I already shared with you that in the US, before I came back to Thailand, you know, they also experienced in higher mercury in the fish. And then they found out that, you know, like the mercury that came out from manufacturing company went to the, if you see here, you know, went to the water stream and the fish eat and intake into body and people take it and cause, you know, some kind of effect. Okay. So this affect the ecological system. And they calculate in terms of, you know, this is name of chemical potential effect, fractional, and like this one. If you remember, I mentioned about fish, okay? So it might come from mining, agricultural, manufacturing, energy production, might be zinc, copper, organic chemical, and damage ecosystem. And it caused, you know, like decreasing in population of fish, decreasing biodiversity, and also affect human health. Okay, this one is in term of interpretation. And here we go. Now, recently, this one is a major topic in Thailand, like right now. This morning, I turned on the television and Khun Sorayut mentioned that right at today at Kampang Thet, AQI go beyond 300. You know, like API 400 is standard, but it go to 300. So, you know, like right now the activity of, you know, like biomass burning, you know, in northern of Thailand affects us a lot. Sadly, if you listen to the from the television right now, before this time, you know, the organization that get rid of the problem about forest fire burning is belong to Ministry of Natural Resources, Forestry Department. So they have division to Forest Fire Control Department. But right now, they transfer responsibility to local government. You know, or in Thailand we call Obotor. So right now in Chiang Mai, you know, every, you know, tiny organization, they have to, you know, like solve this problem by themselves. Yes. You, I just thought, you know, that, you know, right now, you know, the, you know, every, you know, small, you know, organization in Chiang Mai, they have to have a plan, you know, to fighting for forest fire by themselves. You know, so they, I have to say that they let, you know, like the authorization to go to the local level instead of, you know, to be centralized. But for me, I'm not quite sure whether the tiny village or tiny community have able to have, you know, enough equipment, enough plan to do it. But I have, you know, like the professor in Chiang Mai University that I know, they try to help, you know, the Chiang Mai small community to fighting for
PM.
So this one is, you know, where it came from. Fossil fuel, wood burning, dust from roads, dust from fuel, PM10, PM2.5, sulfur dioxide, NOx, and so on. So you already learned about effect of PM, right? So this one is, you know, like something regarding to impact. Let me show you the another slide. I will show you. I'm sorry. Because we start the class earlier, maybe let's take a break later. Okay. I will interview you about
a software.
Okay, that you may use to tell, you know, LCA. Okay. So in this slide, provide you free and paid software. Okay. So I get rid of, you know, some document from this one because the software, the free software that they mentioned in this one is not working anymore. So I keep just the one that's still working to show you.
I don't know, something wrong. Okay.
Can I change?
Okay.
I show you, you know, that, you know, what kind of software that they have. Okay. I just changed the battery.
On Monday.
Okay. So this one is, you know, one thing that why they use software because they have a lot of data. So, you know, like the software can like keep database in one place. Okay. So this one is example of data, you know, from food oil. Okay. So let's see what is available software. Okay. Well, if you see this is the paid one you have to pay. Gabby, Sima Pro, okay, Quantis Soon, Umberto. Okay, the one that I said Ajahn Nathapon bought is Sima Pro. Okay, the second one. Okay, this one is Gabi. Okay, it's German. It's German software, they call Holistic Balance. Okay, so this one is a software that, you know, you can write down, you know, write cycle and flow chart and calculate all other things. They said 30-day trial, okay. So you can see that this one is example window, okay, for Gabi. Okay, you can see it look like window, right? They have the online window for you. So this one is about, you know, like all information, okay. And they also able to provide output in terms of global warming potential acid. Deposition and other things. So also indicating that provide you very good things. And the one that I think among of the most popular Sima Pro, okay. And you know why they also use, you know, LCI, okay, and you know why database of many source. Okay, this is this kind of software. So this one is this one example of input, okay, and also output. So that's why, you know, why people who have money, they prefer this one because it's very handy, okay. Example, you know, whether, you know, if you are working for industry, okay, your company, you know, they're willing to pay, so they can do it. Okay. And they also have another package inside, you know, to do other things, you know, just inform you. And another software they call Quantis. Okay. So this one is web-based application. Okay. So you're able to calculate LCA. So this one is, you know, a window. You see there, they made something easy. The output from this one, it also easy to visualize. And also they have Amboto, okay, from Germany as well. Okay, so this one is the screen to show. So this one just for your information that, you know, if you work for a company, you're luxury enough thinking about this one. How about free software? Okay. Right? We're looking for free software. Okay. So they have a system that called interface only and full package. Okay, OpenLCA. Actually, this software is quite large. I think I'm trying to download, but it's not complete yet. You know, you can download the executable file and install in your system. Okay, let's see. As I already mentioned, they have OpenLCA. And the last three is about building material. They call the project Beast. You know, you know the Beast, right? It represents something building, right? And B also, you know, like a symbol for architecture as well. So they call the software B and antenna. And the last one, EIOLCA, this one is not working anymore. Okay, so I get rid of the one. This one is still working, OpenLCA, okay? It's produced by Clean Delta, okay? It's an open source company, okay? You can do like a manual entry. They also have free database for you to use, and you also can use paid database. So this one is, you know, like the window, you know, to show OpenLCA. If you didn't want to do it yourself, so you can try OpenLCA. Okay, and this one they call BEES, Building for Environment and Economic Sustainability. Okay, so this one is like the software regarding building material. Okay, if you would like to do something regarding to concrete, roofing insulation, piping, cleaning material, you can use this type of software because it's free, okay, in online base, okay. Maybe let I show you
for Beast. Okay, maybe I opened the website. Okay. This one is website for OpenLCA. Maybe I use Google. Okay. So, you know, like you can like download just like a few form and download the software and you're able to try. Okay, as already mentioned, I already done this one, but not installed yet. And another thing, it be, maybe let I copy the keyword. Okay, so this one, it came from the project, you know, from, okay, this one. building environment and economic sustainability, you know, like in a web way that, you know, like you can use. Okay, to calculate, you know, then they have, okay, building material product. If you look at this one, okay, so the B can analyze, if you see here, global warming, acidification, eutrophication, fossil fuel depletion, indoor air quality, and so on. You know, like, if you would like, okay, to, you know, like, for this one, and they also have version 2.1, okay, to do analyze. This one is just only for impact assessment, okay, but for CIMA Pro that I inform you, the paid software, it also helps you to calculate LCI as well. So the free software, you know, they have limited capability, okay? So they provide this kind of information. Okay, let I go back to our PowerPoint. Okay, so this one is bees, okay. Okay, you have, you know, for impact assessment to analyze. After you put all the other, okay, they can provide, you know, like a global warming potential. I think, you know, we can input any chemical, right? Because they just, you know, you just provide information about amount of chemical, and after that, they're going to help you to classify, okay, the impact, okay? And they also have another one they call Antina, i.e. This one also life cycle assessment for building as well. Okay, impact estimator, and also do calculate the, you know, estimator for highway. Okay, they also have eco calculator spreadsheet. Okay, now this one is free software for antenna. Okay, maybe let's take a break for 15 minutes, and after that, I will show you a case study in US, and also case study for, as I mentioned, polyethylene. If you see from the document that I put, I also have another example in it's the, not, I'm not sure whether it's bachelor or master thesis of student in Brain of Songkhla University. They study life cycle in a globe. Okay, medical globe. Okay, so you see, you know, like several examples. And after that, you know, like, because you see some example, I'm also thinking about during your third year and second year that you're taking instrumentation with me, if you still recognize, right? I think, you know, I would like to ask you, you know, to bring back the project that you have done, and, you know, get that kind of information and practice, you know, about LCH. You don't need to find something new, just bring back, you know, like the report, you know, thing that you already study in instrument. And study about, you know, life cycle assessment, because I will show you LCA in something that related to us for producing LDE. You will see that how they do it. And right now you see some kind of software and some kind of example. I think, you know, if you just listen and not practice,
maybe you're not understanding well, right? And you have already have some kind of raw material from instrumentation class. I think, you know, you should practice, you know, like how could you do LCA, you know, like for the project that you already do in, you know, like in Zoom in. Maybe let's take a break for 15 minutes and let's resume class at 2:50. Okay. Okay.